I'd like to welcome everyone tonight to the concert. Glad that y'all were able to make it, and especially happy that the Wind Symphony from Concordia University Chicago is here with us tonight. Just a few announcements before the concert begins. If you look in your program, you'll see that there will be an intermission. There'll be some time during that intermission when you'll hear from a couple of students about their experience at Concordia Chicago, so please remain seated. After that, you'll have plenty of time to use the restroom or whatever you need to do during the intermission. During the intermission and as you leave, you'll see that there are offering plates in the back, and you're invited to make an offering to support the ministry of the Wind Symphony. You can do that in several ways. There's an envelope in your program that you can use to make an offering. If you'd like to write a check, you can make those checks payable to Concordia University Chicago. Also on page 2, there is a QR code if you'd like to make a contribution electronically. The Wind Symphony would like to thank, and I'd like to thank people at Immanuel who did extra work to make tonight's concert possible, especially Matthew Rasmussen, our director of music, and also Kristen Carney, our director of communications. And also we're grateful to Kevin Bodorf and Mark Ennis for streaming the concert tonight. Please join me in a word of prayer before we begin. O God of majesty, whom saints and angels delight to worship, pour out your spirit on your servants, who with the gifts of music enliven our praises and proclaim your word with power. Through the ministry of Dr. Fisher and the Wind Symphony of Concordia Chicago, give us a new awareness of your beauty and your grace. Give them safe travel as they continue their tour. Bless Concordia University Chicago in their mission to form students for vocations in church, family, and the world. We ask these things in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. And now, please help me to welcome Dr. Richard Fisher and the Wind Symphony of Concordia University Chicago.
On behalf of the Wind Symphony and Concordia University, we want to very much welcome you to the concert tonight. We've been missing you. We've been in the rehearsal hall for a couple months, and it's great to get out of the band room and here to be able to share our God-given talents with you. And we hope you very much enjoy this musical journey we're going to take you on today. We're so happy that you could be here. And we hope that you can walk out of this place tonight after this beautiful church and just feel good about having attended it and in some ways changed your life. We hope that happens. We heard Joy in All Things, and it's a beautiful piece. We sort of recognize the hymn, but Joy in All Things, everything, even the struggles that we have in our lives, as well as the joyful things and the happy things that happen in our lives. And then what better piece to do next based on a beautiful Savior, wow, who makes all that possible, who uses everything in our lives for our sake. So you'll hear Beautiful Savior, and it's a beautiful piece. We hope you enjoy this one wonderful work.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening. My name is Ruth Etherton. I'm a freshman at Concordia, and I am in the Lutheran Education Program. And I play bass clarinet in Wind Symphony. One of my favorite things about Wind Symphony is that we get to glorify God every day through our music and through playing. And we get to do that with our friends. And Dr. Fisher just uplifts us and encourages us every day. And the community is just so Christ-centered and uplifting. I'd like to thank our host tonight. Thank you for having us. Thank you for those who provided the meal. You guys are wonderful. We couldn't do it without you. Thank you so very much. And thank you everyone for being here. And I hope you enjoy the rest of the concert.
My name is Nick. I'm now a junior. I'm a theology major at Concordia Chicago. I'm the trumpet section leader. As you can tell by now, I already have an accent. I am from Australia, so you no need to guess. There's Ireland out there. There's some English. I'm Australian, from born and raised in Australia. I'm also the tour manager on this tour. This is our second stop, and I'm so pleased that you guys are all here. It really means a lot, because without you, this could not happen. Without you, it cannot happen. Music is reciprocal. It is given and it is taken, right? And without the taking, how can we give? And so it really is a blessing that you're all here this night. We also want to thank again our lovely hosts for supporting us with a great meal, for supporting us with this lovely sanctuary to play in, to help you and to bless you guys as you have blessed us so greatly. And so I just want to thank you guys again. And I just want to point out that if you love what we're doing, we have some CDs that we recorded a couple of years ago, like Let the Amen Sound, one of our favorites. Again, thank you.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Russell Dawn. I'm president of Concordia University Chicago, and it's a pleasure to be here. You guys make me proud. What a first half that was. Just gorgeous. It's quite an honor and a privilege for us to be here, for the Wind Symphony to be here with you this evening, because you're sharing a bit of your life with us. And just as it's an honor for us to be here sharing your lives, it's an honor for me to be part of Concordia University Chicago. Founded in 1864, it's the original Concordia. For generations, our institution has achieved excellence in nurturing and developing sacred music. And excellence, as Aristotle noted, is never an accident. Almost got that backwards. It's always an accident. Instead, it is always the result of high intention, sincere effort, and excellent execution. That's a perfect description of how Dr. Fisher and these outstanding students have attained the level of excellence you're hearing tonight. Around the same time as Concordia Chicago's founding, Russian author Fyodor Dostoevsky wrote that beauty will save the world. Now, he knew that Christ had already saved the world, so what can the saying mean? It means that even when society forsakes truth and goodness, people will be moved by beauty. And genuine beauty brings truth and goodness with it. So as you listen to the second half of our concert tonight, as you're moved by the beauty of the music, think about how these young people are also conveying truth and goodness. And as you're moved, I also ask that you partner with us. Excellence doesn't happen by accident, and it also doesn't happen without cost. You've seen in your program how to give, and we will appreciate your support of the future of sacred music at Concordia Chicago. Thank you for your generosity, and please enjoy the rest of the concert.
Thank you.
In 1993, I attended a WASB conference, WASB meaning World Association for Symphonic Bands and Ensembles, in Valencia, Spain. And it blew my mind. There were bands from all over the world with all their garb and all their special instruments. I was mesmerized for a week. I had never attended anything like that in my life. And as a result of my passion for the conference, I got elected to be the director of communications for WASB. And WASB conferences happen every 2 years. And so the next one was going to be held in Hamamatsu, Japan. So in 1994, I got to go over with the United States Marine Band director and many other dignitaries from around the United States to put together this 1995 conference. While I was there, I was told about this piece, I heard this piece, and I said, I've got to buy this piece for Concordia. So I purchased Methuselah 2, the piece you're going to hear tonight, and it's been a really prominent place, it has a prominent place in our repertoire, and it features the percussion section, especially the drums. And there's a certain, we've done it before with taiko drums, which is Japan drums, but even some of the Japanese don't use taiko drums. They use the same drums we do. So, and they're very expensive to rent and to purchase, of course. So we hope you enjoy Methuselah 2. But one other thing, there's a chant after the drumming, the oboe begins a chant that's actually in our hymnal someplace. And I know it's in there, so there's a Western part of this, a Christian part of this thing with the chant, bringing together the Japanese and their drumming and all their harmonies and stuff like that, and this chant. And so that's what that is, and then it combines at the end. We hope you enjoy Methuselah 2 by Masaru Tanaka. Thank you.
Thank you. was beneficial for you to be here for us because we love playing for you. That's really what it all is. We talk about that at work all the time. And that's not doing it, we're just not performing in our band room for ourselves. Ultimately, we're just sharing these gifts with you, and we're glad to have you tonight. Again, the evening meal was absolutely fantastic.
Yeah.
We really enjoyed it. Trumpet and wow, we the core bill.
So you know what that means, encore time. But as I always tell people, that this last piece, though short, it might be the best piece of the night because of its message. And just to let you know in advance, when we've been invited twice to play at Carnegie Hall in New York City as the showcase ensemble for the New York City Wind Band Festival, an honor of 2014 and 2019. And the piece you're about to hear, we weren't allowed to do encores. We were not allowed to talk about religion, but we put this piece right in the middle of the program both times, 2014 and 19. 2,000 people heard this piece. And I'm not sure if it's because of the message, hopefully, or the beauty of the piece, or the fact that a band can sing. And all those things happen in this piece. And when we look at the title of this piece, Who Puts His Trust in God Most Just, it's a little scary. He's a just God. He demands perfection. But as we know from John 3:16 and Romans 10:9 and many other Bible verses, that he loved us so much, he cared about us. He yearns to have us in heaven with him for eternity. And so what did he do? He sent Jesus himself to die for us. A horrible, horrible, disgusting, despicable death on that cross. Because of his perfect love, his unconditional love. And so now when we look at the title of this piece, Who Puts His Trust in God Most Just, just God, he doesn't see us, he doesn't see our sins. He sees us, he sees Jesus' perfection. He sees us as perfect. And that's the only way he can see us in order for us to be in heaven for eternity. And that's what this piece is all about. Not just for eternity, though, and day-to-day living as well. And we hope you enjoy Who Puts His Trust in God Most Just, but we hope it's most meaningful to you for the greatest spiritual message that we could possibly hear.